Morning everyone. This is part two of my timing belt change, and I wanted to verify that this timing mark was correct at 1.2, and it is. That's the one correct one we're supposed to be using. Well, I have it lined up with the mark, and over here it's lined up on the cam gear on this side. And it's lined up with the cam gear on this side as well. So, time to get with it. Start taking it apart. Turn this light on. Makes it really easy to get that belt off. There's the other. It's got a little bit of a spring tension. There we go. There's that. Now take this belt. Just slide it off. There we go. That's one. If I remember right, we have to loose or take this one out. Loosen this one. Red Loctite must have glued it underneath that to that. There we go. Okay. And then this bolt has to come all the way out. And this one's got the little hold down bracket with it. Put that aside. Okay, the rest of it we'll get from the other side. Well, didn't work around my light. Move this light for now. All
Okay. Now, let's see if this one will come loose. It won't. Let's glue it down too. Wow. That was really on there. Okay. Now we'll take the tensioner off again. Yeah, I'm just going to go ahead and do the same on this one. I'm going to go ahead and take it all the way off. And there's the second one. Get rid of that. The tensioner still feels pretty good, actually. But I did buy new ones. Okay. And that's the other belt. Okay. Put a little brake clean on this rim. I did buy the brand new tensioners from Honda. And brand new springs as well. Okay. This spring has got like a closed end on that end and open end on that end. The open end goes in here on the tensioner. And then this hangs onto the post like so. And then the washer, of course, goes over this slider hole because one bolt has a washer and one doesn't. So, we'll put the red thread. Don't want these bolts coming loose. For sure. There we go. Some on this other bolt. And screw it down. Leave it loose enough where it'll still turn. They're still slide when I move that. There we go. Now it slides freely. Oops. It's this one here. I was told that Gates was the maker for the original Honda belt, so they say it's basically the same thing. Alright, so we're gonna slide this down inside to the pulley closest to the engine. There we go. And then these things should line up perfectly, which they do. And then push this down. Slide it over like so. Easy peasy. Okay. Now for setting the tension, what I'm gonna do is kind of get a feel for what I think might be it. It gets close there. And I'm going to snug these down. Not tighten all the way, just snug it. And then I got a little contraption here that I had made. Of course, if you've watched any of the videos on guys doing this, just make this out of coat hanger and make your own little deal. And I've got a fish scale that I'm using. And it's just gonna kind of get an idea how close it is. Okay, so put that there. We'll pull down to 4, right there, 4.4. It looks like I'm right at where I need to be. It's right at the top of the mark, which would be 5 millimeter. I made this from 5 to 7, so if it fell within that range, then it would be fine. So it was at the top of the range. So, at 19 foot pounds. Wow, that doesn't seem like much. All right. So that's on correctly. Got the right belt deflection on it, so we're good. We got a brand new spring and a brand new tensioner pulley. So we need to put this back in place. Let me clean the threads off of this one. Alright. Now, put a little bit of my red thread locker on here. I'll put my socket on my bolt, make it a little easier to get it in there, hopefully. 20. This one's got the bracket on it. You gotta make sure that wire is underneath this bracket when you put it in. Pretty good. All right, put some tread locker on that. I'm gonna take this one back out so I can put some red thread locker on it. Clean the bolt up. Okay. Put it in the socket. Oop. Maybe not. Maybe I'll just stick it in the hole first. And screw him in. I couldn't find torque specifications for these bolts, so I guess just good and tight. It's going to be the torque spec for that. All right. Clean up these bolts for the adjuster. Okay. And I got a new adjuster for this side as well. That's the part number in case you want to get one. And if you've seen my other videos, then you know I bought these parts from CarolinaCycle.com. They had the best prices. I've bought from them before, and I've been very pleased with them. They're very professional. Ship it out in a timely manner, and they do a good job. So I highly recommend them. Okay, then I got a new spring, and I'll see the part number on that one if you want it. The spring is 14516-MN5-000. Okay. And then take a new adjuster, put the big end and the adjuster and the looped end. We'll go here. So I'm gonna have to have a bolt ready. So let me put a little bit of red thread locker on this. Okay. Snug this one down. And this one. And make sure it still moves. Okay. Like they give you a sticker for your timing belt cover. Alright, so you gotta feed this through here. Should line up perfectly. And then you take this and push this up like that and slide it over. Easy as peasy. Check my mark's still there. Nothing's moved. Okay, now this belt deflection, I tried making up that tool, tried doing different things. I'm just gonna have to guess. I'm gonna try to get it about the same tension as that one, because there's no way to get everything above this, because you have to pull that way for belt deflection. There's no way to get everything, nothing that I have anyway, that I could do that with. So we're gonna do the best we can with what we got. And I have read that people who've done this job say that that spring tension is usually the right tension, but it doesn't feel as this tight as that one. And whenever I took these off, this one was looser than this one was. So I would imagine they did the same method that I'm going to do here, but I'm going to make sure that this one's tight. Enough, not tight, like, you know, tight, but tight enough. I think I got that too tight already. There we go. I think that's about right. Let me get my little gauge that I made up there. Okay. There's the top of the belt. right there. That feels like about 4 right there, 4 pounds. And it looks like I'm just a little loose compared to the other side, but I'm within the, right in the middle of that mark. So I'm probably 6 millimeter. The other side was 5. I say that's close enough. Okay. Make sure that's 19. Okay. We'll go 90 degrees this way. And then 90 degrees this way. That mark is right on. The crank pulley mark is right on. And the other cam pulley is right on. We're good. Let me rotate this engine a couple times fully around. Counterclockwise. There's nothing hitting. Okay, I think that should be enough. Let me roll this around to the right timing mark. See if we're still in time. Which I'm sure we are. Okay. Those feel perfect. On the timing mark on this one. The crank pulley is right on the timing mark, and it's on the timing mark on this other one. So we're good. Now I gotta take this gasket off for that cover. It got stuck to this, and I'm gonna have to put it back into the cover. Okay, I'm gonna take these bolts out first and put them in a proper order so I don't mix up the length. Now, I'm going to clean this a little bit. We're almost there. Ready to slide in. I'm gonna leave you there and I'm gonna slide this in more here. take that center cover off. Make this a little easier to go in. Gasket still on there. It's on the wrong side of the wire, that's what the problem was. And wire tucked in the inside of it. Okay, I'll make sure the gasket didn't come off. The last thing you'd want is for that gasket to come off and get tangled up into your brand new timing belt. That would not be good. Put this in on the other side. There's looks like 8 of these bolts over there for this cover. Okay, those are all tight. Now, for the other cover. Now, these three bolts are all the same. Same length looks like. Sorry if my head's in the way all the time trying to see. The center cover. Put a little bit of grease in there. cover. It's got an up mark on it. I don't know if you can see that or not, but it's got an up. So it has to go up.
You get so many tools and they're all spread out, and sometimes it gets hard to find them. Okay, I'll give you a light so you guys can see too. I can't see very well myself. Try to move this clamp just a little bit closer. And then slide it on. Kind of handy to have the right tools, makes things go a little easier. And I wish I had the right pliers for this, because they do make these spring clamp pliers. I will get some one day, a little bit fatter jaw. I don't know why I haven't bought any to this point. I use this kind of stuff all the time, whether it's on cars or whatever. Spring tension on it. Tapping on that. Okay. And then, good enough. And slide the cover, the seal. Now, I need to put this Y pipe tube in. You gotta be careful with these clamps too. You don't strip them out because they will strip out. I'm probably gonna have to re-change this antifreeze anyway, because I'm gonna fill it up with. I looked through my stuff and I have one bottle of the Pro Honda antifreeze coolant. So I went through the owner's manual and looked and seen what it said, and it said just to make sure it's a certain kind. That's what I did. I bought a Walmart brand for now, and I'm gonna put it in it. It says it's good for aluminum engines. It's good for all engines, including aluminum engines, so I'm gonna try it. I may leave it in for a little while and then drain it out. So that's all buttoned up. I don't have a magnetic socket. Wish I did. Spark plugs. I'm gonna have to get one, but I just do it this way. Ratchet. I'm not gonna bore you with putting all the plastics back on. I'm gonna go ahead and fill it full of antifreeze coolant, and then start it up, show you the final product. And then we'll call it a day. All right. Oh, I almost forgot about the tube here. Okay. Let's see if you can see anything. Sling down. Rubber lip's kind of flimsy. Doesn't want to go over too easily. Make sure it's all the way on. Socket. Grab a hold of it with my magnet so it doesn't just drop into the hole, damage the electrode. They're going to be tight this time. I don't know who did this last time, but I think they were afraid to tighten them. on. Okay, that's all done. Okay, I think everything's together except for the plastics. Okay, this is the cool one I was telling you about. It says on the back, back there, it's safe for aluminum engines. Alright, well, let's go ahead and start it up. I'll make sure nothing's leaking down here first. Yeah, I don't see anything. Alright, you ready for this? Put the choke on. It's probably gonna idle pretty fast. Topping that off, and then put all my plastics back on, and that'll do it. So it's a pretty easy job. I think according to the time on this, it was an hour and 45 minutes. The first film took an hour and 11 minutes, so right at 3 hours to get to this point with filming it and doing it. So I probably got maybe half hour to put everything else back on. So, you know, 3.5 hour job, that's not too bad. Starts and runs good, sounds good, so everything's fine. So, all right, well, thanks for watching.